right, so last night I was just like scrolling through Facebook, you know, doing the things on the phone. I happened upon Flight Test Fans. If you guys aren't familiar, check out Flight Test Fans. We'll put a link below. It's kind of like the Flight Test community page. Our buddy Chris Kramer, I don't know how you say your last name. He posted an interesting comment that sparked my imagination. He says, has anyone attached a flappy thing to the outside of a brushless motor to make it sound like a piston engine? Sort of like a cardan bicycle spokes from when we were a kid, which I did all the time.
All the time.
Or you run over the can and it goes up into the thing and it sounds like a dirt bike two-stroke. Yeah, today, we have the FT Mustang. For those of you guys who aren't familiar, this is one of our designs. This is a swappable series. Everything that you see here is this dollar store foam board. We got popsicle sticks. We got all common materials, glue, a little bit of RC components, and boom, you got a sweet flying RC plane. If you haven't seen the build video or anything like that, if you're new to the channel, check the links below. We'll put some info down there for you guys. It is also the Bushstang, if you haven't seen that video. I found her. She had been a little bit neglected, and I'm sorry. It looked like she had been scalped of some of her parts and her belongings, but I reassembled her, got a motor in, and then not just any motor, but check this out. I used a little bit of gaff tape. I glued a little bit of a barbecue skewer.
Okay, I see you.
And I don't know what's gonna happen. I haven't done it yet. Let's do a quick run up and see what kind of sound effects we're gonna get with this thing. All right, so this is the Mustang bicycle card spoke Rolls Royce V12 engine test run up. Take one, commence.
Okay,
right, we're on to something, dude.
I feel good about this one. Just some gaff tape and some skewer, bro.
Chris, I can't thank you guys enough. If you guys haven't checked out Flight Test Fans,
check it out.
Probably the coolest group of people on the internet. Mm-hmm. We love you guys, and we do what we do because of you guys, so thank you.
And we're going to fly this thing.
Let's try it.
Dude, man. Let's just see what happens.
So Josh is out, and he's doing some meetings and stuff. He's actually working on some of the stuff for the new property, which is super exciting. We're making headway every single day, and so Josh is doing that, but when he gets back, if this goes the way I think it's gonna go, we should have Josh test out the Mustang. He'll be like, dude, Alex, why do you want me to fly your crappy old Mustang? But as soon as he fires it up, dude. So stay tuned for Jay Bix. We'll have him fly it as soon as he gets back. So the nice thing about snowstorms is normally, at least
you know which way the wind's
at
going.
At least this one, doesn't look like there's tons of wind, and you can see where the wind is coming from and where it's going.
Vroom, vroom, son.
All right, dude. Here
Ready?
Goes my van.
Yes!
Oh dang, I was wrong. There's some definite wind over the building.
It's super white out here.
Dude, it sounds like, doesn't necessarily sound like a real Mustang, but no. It does sound like a gas model engine. Kinda sounds like a two-stroke or something.
Okay.
It's flying wonky though, I'm not gonna lie about it.
Well, I mean, he did have gaff tape and a skewer and a
No, it's not that. There's other things going on.
Yeah, give me a full throttle.
All right, here, we'll come downwind.
Yeah, buzz the tower.
Here we go.
Oh, yeah!
Dude,
crushing it, dude.
Coming in hot.
Oh, dang, dude, what's going on?
It just was like, wham, it got hit by like a gust.
Whoa, dang, dude.
The an arctic mile gust. That was fun while it lasted.
Well,
I think we're good though. I'm gonna go back inside. We're gonna make a quick repair. We just got a little bit of droopy nose syndrome.
Droopy nose.
You get that a lot, you know, when you do nose dives. I'm gonna get this fixed up in time for Josh to fly it. All right, so we fixed it up. Josh is still gone, not back yet, but that's okay. And the reason why is because we got a special package in the mail. Secret Lab, as you can tell. If you aren't familiar with Secret Lab, that's okay because you're about to be. They make probably the coolest computer / gaming kind of chairs that I've ever seen. But a lot of people think that it's all fun and games and just flying all day, when in reality, we actually spend probably 90% of our time sitting on a computer.
Not flying, doing other things.
Yeah, and so the guys at Secret Lab hooked us up with these awesome chairs, mm-hmm. and we've been anticipating this for quite
so
some time.
So excited, dude.
Without further ado, we're going to put these together, and then we're gonna
sit on it.
Let's do it, dude. Woo! All right, so secret lab chairs have been assembled, yes. And I have to say they're pretty cool. Just look at this. I got the space ash. Gray. It's technically ash. Called ash. I call it space gray. Austin's is one of my personal faves as well. He got the. You can't really.
Carbon fiber.
I don't know if you can tell, but it looks like real carbon fiber.
I have what I like to call the nicest one.
Josh, what you working with,
dude,
man?
I love orange, and I love, like, ever since I saw that carbon cup, I've been infatuated with it. So check this out. I got the
dude,
orange and
it's
black.
It's just like Corey Robbins' carbon cup.
On top of that, I have a terrible back issue, so I got the lumbar support.
Stefan.
Boom.
He's got the smaller version, the Omega.
Omega with the Royal, bro.
Loving it. Beautiful. So again, Secret Labs, thank you guys for hooking it up. Woo. Check the link below if you're looking for a high quality, top of the line computer chair, gaming chair.
If you go through that link, then you're actually helping Flight Test out as well. So go through that link and get your chair because it's freaking awesome.
Without further ado, we said that as soon as Josh gets back, we're gonna have him fly the plane. You've seen this plane before.
You brought it back.
It's back.
It's back.
But it's back in a way that you could imagine.
Dude, does it still have the new motor on it?
No, it's a different motor because somebody scalped my motor.
I did. I scalped the motor.
I had to bring her back to life.
Is there a bomb in it?
No bomb.
The Swede did the bomb thing to me already.
No,
so.
This isn't a bomb, even though that's a great idea. I will be honest, the plane doesn't fly good at all because it's been whomper jawed. All right, so Stefan's going to give you a little launchy toss. You just got to give it some throttle.
We going in.
I just want to see what you think when this thing launches. All right,
three,
ready?
Three, two, one.
Dude, you put a sound card in it.
How that's possible?
Isn't a piece of tape?
Tell him, bro.
What do you put a piece of plastic? This reminds me of the.
No, Ray, this is what happened. You take the motor, you put some gaff tape, and have two little pieces hang off the end.
Dang, dude.
Then you put a barbecue skewer next to it and go.
It's just like a card in a bicycle.
Dude, I love it.
Dude, I love it.
Thanks to Chris Kramer, right?
Yeah, on Flight Test Fans last night. Here it comes.
That's
dude,
so cool.
Alice, I know what you're talking about. It still flies fantastic.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I could barely fly this plane earlier. He's coming in inverted. I could barely keep it in the air. I crashed it.
You did, dude. Why are you so good at flying?
Here comes. Night.
The motor fell off.
How many times? It's the softest landing across the
island. It just...
It's a VTOL.
I like that.
Shout out to Flight Test Fans. If you guys aren't familiar, check them out on Facebook. It's the coolest group on Facebook. Yeah. And it's where all the fellow flight testers, everybody from the Flight Test family, they get together there. They share their ideas. And it's just a great place to be in general.
They are the jewel of what Flight Test is.
They fill my Facebook feed with all kinds of non-dramatic kind of stuff, which is what you need to see when you're on Facebook. So I appreciate you guys very much. If you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you do so. We'll see you guys next time.
See ya.